bleed, there's wash and never stay. A wife and naked in the night and looking for some play. Just another girl that wants to rule the world at any time or place. And when she gets into your head, you know she's there to stay.
Everyone, I'm Harry, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to do another How to Sound Like video. This time we're going to try and get the tolerance on Molly's Chambers by Kings of Leon. So before we get started, if you like this Sound Like video at any point, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. There's going to be affiliate links down in the description to every piece of gear I used in this video and to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I'd really appreciate you going and check them out. So this is a very, very early Kings of Leon song, probably the first one I heard, and it's off my favourite album by them, Youth and Young Manhood. So it's full of great low to medium gain overdrive tones. I should say I managed to find a full multi-track of this, so I was actually able to isolate the guitar parts and listen that way so I could get the tones a bit closer. But that also means that you're hearing all the original instruments on the intro song except from the guitar parts where I recorded my own in. So I needed a pedal that was actually going to be able to handle this, because believe it or not, the gain tones on this are actually quite low, especially Matthew's part that I played on the Les Paul is almost clean and it just breaks up when you dig in. So I needed a dynamic overdrive, and then Caleb's part on the 335 is a little bit more driven, but we'll get into that further on. So the pedal that I decided to use is actually the Dane by Thorpe FX. This is hands down one of the best overdrive pedals that I've ever played. It does have a boost on there as well, which is also one of the best clean boost / general tone enhancement circuits that I've played as well. It would be worth the price just for either side of this, but the fact that you have a great overdrive and boost circuit in one pedal makes this a really, really strong pedal. It's definitely in the top three overdrives, if not taking my number one spot. The reason I chose this is because I really needed a great dynamic pedal, so when I'm playing the... it's quite clean, but then when I dig in, it's overdriving a little bit more. And then, of course, for the lead parts, it's nice to have like a bass overdrive tone and then a boost running into that. So that's exactly what I did with the Dane. So I recently did a full demo of the Dane. So if you'd like to see that, there'll be a link up in the cards in the description and pinned in the comments. So we'll look at Caleb's parts first. So this is kind of like the main rhythm track. Now, this is a bit more driven than Matthew's parts that he plays for the rhythm parts. When it goes to his lead part, that is a bit more gainy, but we'll look at that after. So I had settings on the Dane like this, and that was exactly the same the whole way through the song. Everything else is just about how hard you're actually digging into the guitar for the different parts in the song. So obviously I used my 1959 Reissue ES335. This has Monty's low output PAF humbucking pickups, which are great vintage style humbuckers. The amp I'm using today is my Cornell Romney Pro, which is kind of like a Fender Tweed version on Blackface territory. And that's been recorded by a Louis MTP440 dynamic microphone, which is like an SM57 with a tiny bit more bass. So if I quickly show you what the 335 sounds like going straight into the amp, and then we'll kick on the Dane with the settings that I use so you can hear what the overdrive is actually doing to our bass clean tone. So the 335 straight in sounds like this.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go, you can see what the Danes actually do, and it's giving us a nice little medium gain overdrive to kind of match Kayla's parts on the original song. So I'll actually pull out my guitar parts isolated from the intro song now so you can see and hear exactly what's going on. You'll see the settings of the Dane pedal on screen as well. Okay, so now for Matthew's parts. In the early Kings of Leon stuff, I've seen him play a Les Paul live a lot, so I decided to use my 1958 reissue Gibson Les Paul, again with Monty's Law output PAF humbucking pickups, which are great vintage style humbuckers. I have the settings on the Dane very clean, so when I'm playing like the little... it's almost clean, and then when I'm digging in, you can hear it break up a little bit, and that's our bass overdrive time that I use throughout the whole song for Caleb's rhythm track. There is a third guitar, which is like overdubs where it's lead, and for that I was using the boost. So for the main rhythm track, I had settings like this, and then for the little third guitar overdubs, I had the boost engaged with settings like this running into the overdrive. So if I quickly show you what the Les Paul sounds like going straight into the amp, and then I'll kick on the Dane with the overdrive so you can hear what it sounds like on the rhythm track, and then I'll kick on the boost so you can hear what the lead little overdub parts sound like as well. So the Les Paul straight into the amp sounds like this. So there you go, you can hear what the Dane is actually doing to our tone. It's very much like an EQ sculpt, but also giving us a tiny bit of drive. You don't really hear it on the main verse parts, but as soon as I dig in for the chorus parts, you really do hear it. And then of course, having the boost for the lead parts as well. So I'll pull out Matthew's rhythm track first so you can see and hear exactly what's going on, and you'll see the settings of the Dane on screen. Okay, so now I'll quickly pull out the third guitar part, which is the overdub with the little lead overdubs and the solo part. Again, I had the boost running into the drive, exactly the same drive settings as the rhythm track, and then the boost settings were like this. So the lead overdub part isolated from the intro song sounds like this. You'll see the settings of the Dane on screen as well. So there we have it. That was the Look Out to Sound Like Molly's Chambers by Kings of Leon. Definitely one of my favourite songs by them, and from their probably their best album in my opinion. For me, it's kind of a toss-up between Youth and Young Manhood and Heartshake Heartbreak. They're both killer albums. Their other stuff is really good as well, but it's a bit more spotty. I think every track on both of those albums is really, really good. Of course, having the Les Paul and the 335 to do the different guitar parts, the Les Paul for Matthew's parts, and the ES-335 for Caleb's parts really came in handy. But the thing that really got us close to this was the Dayton. Having that low to medium gain overdrive that is incredibly dynamic really got that indie tone that we hear on the original recording. And then the nice little bonus feature of having that boost running into the overdrive for the little lead overdub parts as well. It's a really killer pedal. I really can't recommend it enough. I'm kind of in love with this pedal. If I could only have one overdrive on my board, it would definitely be that. And that's not included in the boost side. You get a boost as well, which is really, really cool. Again, if you want to see my full demo of the Dayton, there'll be a link up in the cards, in the description, and pinned in the comments. Again, there's also going to be affiliate links down in the description to every piece of gear I used in this video and to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I'd really appreciate it if you go and check them out. Let me know down in the comments how close you thought I got to the original song and any future How to Sound Like videos you'd like to see me do. If you did like this Sound Like video, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. Other than that, go onto my channel, check out some of my playlists. I have plenty more lessons, covers, gear demos, How to Sound Like videos, and anything guitar related. As always, I've been Harry, and thanks for watching.